Welcome to Brighter Dallas. I'm Lisa Luby Ryan, and I am so excited to be a part of this organization. There is an amazing group of young people that are joining this group, and the energy is unbelievable.
We have another great turnout. We have a lot of people showing up. It's good to see a lot of people that came to our first and second event, and it's great to see a lot of new faces too. We have Railroad Commissioner Michael Williams here. He's going to talk a little bit about what the Railroad Commission does and about how Dallas can be affected by what the Railroad Commission does, and especially people from our demographic.
Thank you for inviting me to spend some time with you and fellowship with your friends and see some old friends like Lewis and Lisa and others, and meet some new friends as well. But there's a danger for an elected official to be standing with his back to a wall. So we're going to make this fairly short if you don't mind. You know, in 1986, I was a 33-year-old prosecutor in the United States Department of Justice. I was a prosecutor in charge of the case, the United States of America versus 5 members of the Carolina Knights of the KKK. 4 years later, I was the Assistant Secretary for Education for Civil Rights in the Department of Education. I had the same position under President Bush that Clarence Thomas had under President Reagan. And I issued the directive in 1990 that said colleges and universities should stop issuing financial aid dollars and setting aside seats in their classrooms based upon one's bloodline. The New York Times said it was a frontal assault to race-based affirmative action.
Right now there are a lot of bills in front of the U.S. Congress, and there are a lot of bills that affect Texas and Dallas in front of the Austin Capitol too. We want to make sure we're aware of how those bills are going to affect Dallas. We want to make sure we raise awareness and give people the tools they need on a local level to make decisions that are going to impact them locally.
Every time we get together, there's a new idea or a new concept or a new person that steps up and says, I'll do this for the future of our city. And we're excited to be a part of it. And I think you'll see a difference through this group of young people that come every month to be a part of this organization.
When people ask me about Brighter Dallas and say, why are you attracted to it? I say it's because it starts right here, and you can start locally, and that's important, and it just builds upon itself. And you get people coming in, and you get people who are interested, and versus saying, well, this country's too big, how do I affect that? Well, you say, well, let's just look internally and look locally to Texas. Let's look at Dallas. Let's look at counties. How do you do that? And I think CORT's done an excellent job of organizing that, getting people really excited and saying, yeah, I can make an impact and do that. And I would say for people who are skeptical and people who are wondering why should I be a part of this, I would say that you can make an impact because it happens here and it happens at this level, and it's important.
It's always great to see, you know, 50, 60, 100 people turn out to be involved in an organization like this, to get serious about helping different issues around the city, from social issues to political issues. And this is another great turnout. We're excited about our next event. We have some great speakers lined up, and look forward to hopefully seeing everyone at our next event.
Go to our website, brighterdallas.com, and become a part of what this young group of people are doing for the future of our city.